Atif in New Brunswick. You're on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning.
Hey, good morning, Bill.
How are you?
I just wanted to make a comment.
Sure.
I live in New Jersey. I'm a doctor. I take care of patients every day, and I happen to be Muslim.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, this is very sad to me that people actually, you know, I find it very hard to believe that any Muslim, let alone thousands, let alone 30 or 40 people, were celebrating on 9/11. It just didn't happen. We were as appalled and as scared as anybody else. And quite frankly, you know, we live in an age of cell phones. I would challenge anybody to find one, you know, video or photo or a police record showing that someone had to get deployed to kind of go.
Well, Atif, let me ask
you. Find these.
Let me ask you.
I played,
and I can hear the emotion in your voice, and I empathize with you, because I think as an American Muslim, it's very hard to even have the conversation, knowing that so I get that.
Because Bill, the thing is, and I honestly feel this is true, there's an agenda to otherize us. This is the otherization of Muslims in America, and certain people benefit hugely from this, you know, the Trumps and the
Atif, what about what I said the other day, and I told this story, I told it on this air, and I said the story on Chasing News as well, that one of the things that has struck me about this whole conversation is that where are Muslims in America in en masse rising up and absolutely aggressively condemning not just Muslim extremists, but also these countries over there that not only harbor terrorists, train terrorists, but then just act in a way that is so contrary to everything that we stand for in terms of our values in America. You know, I told the story about my great-grandfather, who, when my grandfather was deployed as a U.S. Marine, and on a ship at Guadalcanal during World War II, my great-grandfather was questioned by the FBI, you know, because he was Italian and Mussolini was our enemy. And years later, my dad asked him, he said, you know, were you mad at the FBI? Were you mad at America? Did you blame them? And my great-grandfather said, I didn't blame the FBI. I didn't blame America. I blamed Mussolini. And, you know, that to me is a very important point. And I'm not so sure, Atif, that message is getting out there. I don't see that same sentiment.
You're right. The message is not getting out there. But Muslim Americans, every size, color, stripe, every organization is condemning this as strongly as they can. I mean, you know, do we call on white men to condemn, you know, every time a white guy kills, you know, goes and shoots something up in the name of whiteness?
Atif, though, but Atif, forget that. Racism and isolated incidents like the Charleston shooting, etc., don't have that common thread of an aggressive terrorist movement that's out there that has a commonality of Islam. I mean,
just say that we are condemning it. If you're not hearing it, it's because you're not listening to it. But that condemnation is out there. But I just want to focus back on this. The 30, you know, whether it was 1,000 or 30 people, it just didn't happen because, again, we live in an age of cell phones. Everyone has even in 2001, everyone had at least a camera.
Phone. I would have thought that too. I don't know that it was as prevalent in 2001 as it is today, where everybody's snapping video on everything. I only have about 30 seconds, but I got to ask you, do you think Mayor Rudy Giuliani was lying about that?
I would say find me a police record. If you deployed cops to control a crowd, there's got to be a paper trail. And I would challenge him to show me that.
Yeah. Okay. Well, there you go. Atif, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.